Hi, this is Andy McMillan, and I'm here to talk to you today a little bit about a very frequently asked question regarding BACnet SC. And that is, what exactly is BACnet SC, and why is it important? So let me start with the first half of that. What is BACnet SC? Well, there are a couple ways to look at it. In a strategic sense, BACnet SC is one more step on the continuum to interoperable, secure building automation systems. Of course, BACnet already provides the interoperable foundation for those systems with interoperable data formats and message exchange and event management and alarms and all of the other current capabilities of BACnet. And what BACnet SC is doing is adding inherent security capabilities. Now, as you probably already know, there are many building automation systems incorporating BACnet that are already secured. But the security happens outside of the BACnet protocol, using things like virtual private networks, or using separation of the building automation system network from the IT network, or in some cases, sophisticated firewalls and specific router configurations. So those security features are still valid and still work. But BACnet SC starts to move some of the security inherently into the protocol itself. So that's the strategic component of BACnet SC. Now, in a technical sense, what BACnet SC is doing is providing a new data link option in the BACnet spec. And that BACnet SC data link includes message security. So BACnet SC, in this sense, is like MSTP or BACnet IP. It's just one of the options you have when you say you want to create or purchase a BACnet device. Now, BACnet SC specifies that the message security will be created and provided through an encryption of the messages as they pass between one device and another. And that encryption process ensures that no device can interact with the message that isn't authorized to do that. That is, no one can view the message that's not supposed to or tamper with it as it is in transit between the devices. Now, that might lead you to ask a natural question, which is, so can devices using the BACnet SC data link work with BACnet devices using the other data links, like BACnet IP and MSTP? We'll talk about those a bit more in our next segment.